tempting to say that you should be reflecting all of the time, especially when you're using reflection for evaluation. In fact, we do reflect all of the time. Life is a constant and ongoing process of reflecting on the actions that we do minute by minute and thinking about whether they've worked out and how we can do things differently. But when we're using reflection as the basis for evaluating a project, as the basis for assessing our research and seeing whether we can make it more rigorous so that we get more valid conclusions and findings, then it can help to have a bit more structure in terms of when we reflect. So roughly, there are two times when one might reflect. There's reflection in action. So that's reflection that happens during an event, during a decision point. And at this stage, you may very quickly think, oh, this isn't going so well, I'll change and I'll do something different. So that's pretty instant, pretty instantaneous. And in fact, you probably wouldn't find yourself recording that reflection at the time. The recording will come later. So that's reflection in action. The other type of reflection is reflection on action, which will happen after the event, the critical incident, the decision point. And it's where you sit down, give yourself some time for the reflection process, have a think about what worked well, what didn't work so well, write it down, and think it through and then plan for future action. And indeed, planning for future action, reflecting on action or for action, is another type of reflection. And really, if you aren't reflecting for action, no point in reflecting at all. So pretty continual, but at key decision points as well. So if at any point you've had to deliberate over a decision that you've made, have a reflect to think about why you made that decision and, you know, the implications of it, and then you can come back later and think about, did it all work well? Also, this fits in with the need to record reflection, because it makes sure the reflection gets done if you've got a structure for recording that reflection, and it also allows other people to engage with the reflection and a constructive dialogue to be built up. Just thinking about, some people propose that reflection should happen right at the end of a project to learn lessons for the future. In fact, it's arguable that if you're reflecting at the end of a project, it's too late, because you can't learn the lessons yourself. The project can't benefit from those lessons. A future project may, but why waste the opportunity not to learn from your own reflection and let others learn in the project you're working on at a particular time?